Hi there. In this tip, I'd like to talk a little bit about the vertex weight tags and the restriction of deformers and how those two sort of go together. So let's start small. What is a vertex? Well, one of these, a point. So that's out of the way. Secondly, what is a vertex weight? Well, currently all these vertices are normal. They're all weighted at 100% or 0%. They don't have a weight associated to them. But in Cinema 4D, you can add a weight to a particular vertex. For instance, if I select this one vertex right here, and I go up to the Select menu, and I say Set Vertex Weight, I can set its weight from 0 to 100%. I can add or subtract. So if I set it to 100%, you'll notice that we now have a vertex weight tag, a vertex map tag, rather. And this point now has sort of a yellow influence around it. Let's make this a little bit more clear. If I use the loop selection and I select a few loops of vertices, and then I go to the select menu and set vertex weight to 100%, I now have an area that is clearly yellow and it fades off into red. I can then select these two loops adjacent and set their vertex weight to 50%, and it sort of fades off a little more gently. So this is another type of point selection. In one of my previous tips, I spoke about polygon, edge, and point selections. But this one can actually be used to influence deformers. So here's how that works. I'm going to switch over to a project here. It's a statue of David. I downloaded it from a free resource, which I will include in the notes for this video. And what I would like to do to this statue is twist the lower half. So I have a twist deformer as a child of the statue already, and I sort of want it down just below the clothing, and I want to twist it. So I'm just going to drag the handle and twist it just about 360 degrees. So that's what I want, except I don't want his hand and the sword to go along with it. Now, I could try moving the twist deformer, but that doesn't really work. I can try the different modes, limited, within box. Well, within box does it, but with some really nasty side effects. So I'm just going to leave it at limited and show you how to solve this sort of problem with a vertex map and a vertex weight. So I'm going to turn the deformer off for just a second. Now, I'm going to start by selecting his arm and the sword because we want to preserve that. So I'm just going to go to the lasso selection, make sure only select visible elements is off, and then I'm just going to select right around his arm. Let's try to get his entire arm all the way up to the armpit area. And so now we have a selection. By the way, I did some polygon reduction to this statue after importing it. So if you download it, it's going to be a lot more detailed. So now that I have this selection, I can set that selection. Let's just save that for now. The next thing we can do is we can basically select his lower half and say we'd like to set the vertex weight of that. So I'm going to select his object again, and I'm going to drag a lasso around pretty much all the points right up to where the clothing ends, and we're going to select that. Now, in our previous tip, we learned that we can now deselect his arm and the sword simply by selecting that tag and saying deselect points. We can now go to the select menu and say set vertex weight. And we want to set the weight to 100% so that if we were to deselect everything and just select the vertex weight tag, we see that everything below the clothing is yellow for 100% and everything above it is red for 0%. His arm is also red for 0%. We can now double click this and it gives us a paint tool to actually paint. And we can actually change the mode from add, erase, smooth. Smooth is what we want. So we can actually go in and smooth the vertex map. So you see as we paint, it sort of smooths it out. And uncheck visible only. Let's make the radius a little bit bigger. And then we can basically just smooth this area out. And it just sort of blends the vertex weight to make a smoother transition. So I'm going to turn the strength down and We can just sort of work this until it's a nice smooth transition. You'll notice we're getting his arm in there, but that's okay. We'll fix that in a bit. So now we have a nice smooth transition from 0 to 100%. We can then say, okay, well, we need to make his arm 0%. So what we can do is we can double click this tag, and then we can go select, set vertex weight, and set it back down to 0. So if we, whoops, I needed to have the tag selected when I did that. Otherwise, it creates a new vertex tag. So I'm going to select the same tag I had, and I'm going to say select, set vertex weight, 0%. And it sets his arm back to pure red. So this is what we want. What does this enable us to do, however? If we turn our deformer back on, it's the same. Nothing has changed. Well, that's because we need to actually tell our deformer to use this vertex map for restriction. So we can select our deformer, and we go to Cinema 4D Tags, Restriction. You'll notice the deformer sort of turns off, because now it has a restriction tag that needs to tell it what it can influence. So if I were to drag this vertex map into one of the slots, we see that now it's only influencing what the vertex map says it can. Even if I were to slide this deformer up a little bit, at a certain point, it's going to stop influencing the geometry. It only influences what's painted above 0%. And of course, it influences 100% things the most and 0% things the least. So, kind of an abstract example, but maybe applied a little bit, and we can actually see how you can twist one part of some geometry, leaving another part of the geometry completely intact using a vertex weight tag and a restriction tag on the deformer. So I hope you enjoyed this tip, and if you did, I'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Until next time, see ya.